Now, is it the responsibility of the Her Majesty's government? I will call it Her Majesty's government.
Yes.
You see,
not Boris Johnson.
Her Majesty's government must have some honesty.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
you can't become Majesty without honesty.
Yes.
Now, if there is honesty, there must be candid disclosure. You make candid disclosure in fairness. Now, fairness is one concept of British justice that we have learned.
Yes.
Now, I assumed my career in the Attorney General's Department as a Crown Counsel. Because at that time, we were a dominion status. Mm. So, we were very proud to be Crown Counsel. Because one noble task of a Crown Counsel is not merely to prosecute, but to be fair in your prosecution. If there is some material to the adversarial party, the party against whom you are presenting the case, that is in your position, you must disclose it. That is one fundamental lesson. Don't win cases by suppressing material. That is one fundamental
case. This is the British rule.
Yes, of course. And admirable rule. And that is what Lord Naseby is doing. He's a Privy Councillor. He knows the law. He knows the concepts that the British have stood for in centuries. I'm not saying that this attitude is a British attitude. This is some attitude which is influenced by political considerations. For they have political and other purposes they are doing this. But the British tradition has been to be fair. The fundamental concept of British administrative law is that it must be fair. And to be fair, you have to disclose whatever material that is in your possession, which in any some way can assist a fair hearing of the matter.
Yes.
Not to assist some particular part, but a fair hearing of the matter. Now, this Anton Gash, who had this military status of a diplomatic status, has given a very fair account. When you go through this, he has given a very fair account. It's a day-to-day dispatch. Now, the military aspects of it. I will just briefly say military aspect is definitely not a matter of human rights.
Yes.
Now, this is a separatist war, terrorist war. Now, he has given this the correct complexion. It is not just a few bands of terrorists like the IRA. This is not IRA type of terrorism. They had 7 airstrips.
Exactly.
They had 4 aircraft. They had mercenary pilots. Now, Anton Gash has specifically said that those 3 flights were manned by mercenary pilots, because he says the way that they flew the aircraft in a zigzag manner below radar. And once the 3 aircraft were shot down, and one was shot down just near our hangar of the Air Force hangar of the Kafir fighter jets. So they knew exactly where the Kafir fighter jets were there. It is 150 meters away. It was shot down.
All this is here.
All that is here. Then the other one came to the Air Force headquarters. And that's the one that crashed into when the pilot was shot, it crashed into the Inland Revenue Building, 9th floor, and into the Cinnamon Lakeside Hotel. Third one, they found with this the intact, it was shot down, and C4 explosives.
Yeah.
Anton Gash himself has seen the C4 explosives. So, he says the 4th aircraft was not used because mercenary pilots were not available.
Yeah.
So, he has drawn that inference. So, they were using mercenary. Then they had a submarine manufacturing assembly plant. Submarine. Now, their submarines were human bombs, which go underwater. Only thing is they couldn't get this oxygen inside, so the head part of it is only... They have rammed so many vessels of the Sri Lanka Navy with that. So that facility was also... So they had a fully fledged army, navy, air force. So the government of Sri Lanka had to contend with that.